For a while now, I've been trying to find the most efficient and cost-effective way to build a creative space. I always felt as if my desk was covered in unnecessary items that built up clutter and never provided me any more happiness than I already had. After months of planning and readjusting, I finally found a space I can call my own and build my best ideas. Following a simple and modern aesthetic, I've made my desk the centerpiece for developing my creative ideas. Not only did I focus on the productivity workflow, but I also made sure it was where I would feel the most comfortable and happy when making videos, designing, or learning new skills. For someone like me, sometimes being in front of a camera can be extremely uncomfortable, and I'm sure many of you feel the same way. Ensuring I'm comfortable in the space helps me break those barriers. Now, I won't be only talking about the tools that make this desk set up the way it is, but also the placement and atmosphere of the space to enhance the environment where I can be most creative and most productive. Recently, my girlfriend and I moved into a new apartment, so we had a blank canvas to start building our space and provide us the most comfortable work-from-home environment. So I want to start off this desk setup tour with the centerpiece of my desk setup, which is a Samsung 34-inch CH890 4K ultra-wide monitor with 100Hz refresh rate. The reason why I actually picked this monitor, though, was because I used to previously use a dual monitor setup, and I actually saw that I was less productive having two monitors instead of one. The reason why was because I would be working on one monitor while watching YouTube on the other. And in doing that, I wasn't as productive, and I felt like the quality of my work diminished because I wasn't focused on what I was doing. For me, I thought multitasking was the key to being more productive, and in fact, I was actually less fulfilled and less happy with my work because I was so distracted on comparing what I was doing on one screen to what I was actually doing on the other. To support the Samsung 34-inch monitor, I use a Wally monitor arm I got from Amazon. The reason why I picked this monitor arm was because it wasn't a fixed monitor arm, and in fact, I was able to raise and lower and adjust the tilt and pan of wherever I needed to be on the desk. The reason why it's so important for me too is that the monitor itself isn't standard by a single pole, and I can actually adjust it based on where my peripherals and other parts of the desk is actually moving. So it provides me that little bit more flexibility and creativity if I want to change the setup at all, as well keep a clean, open space for where I can write, use my computer, or whatever else I need to be doing. Now to support the monitor and all the other peripherals that I have on my desk, I use the Uplift desk, which allows for custom settings for hiding and adjustments for sitting and standing. The reason why I picked the Uplift desk over the brands is because I actually used other standing desks in the past, and I felt the Uplift desk was the best quality. I was able to adjust the type of legs as well as the custom settings in terms of what kind of buttons I wanted to pick from. I was also able to change the colors as well as change the tabletop to which matched the aesthetic of my apartment. For me, the use of custom settings has been extremely important from being able to switch from sitting to standing, especially now that I've been having to work from home and having to sit more for longer hours instead of being able to walk around and be on field all the time. This has allowed me to ease my back and have less back pain and less joint pain to where I'd be able to stand and be able to be adjusting my posture and be able to be more productive. Now onto the systems I use. I have an Apple ecosystem with a PC ecosystem. I use a 2020 M1 MacBook Pro 13-inch for my creative and client work, where I focus primarily on photo editing and video editing on that system. The reason being is that the Apple ecosystem has been so efficient to where I can transfer data from my phone, my iPad, over my laptop to where I can be able to send clients work directly through email or through text. This has been great for me to be able not have to always switch to my phone, and I can be focused on one peripheral at a time. The color accuracy of MacBook Pro monitors as well as the monitor for the Samsung allows me to switch back and forth from having to sit on the couch and be able to work and be able to switching back to my desk when I need to. This allows for more flexibility to where I can work wherever I want and not always have to be stuck at a desk the whole entire time. I also use a PC for other tools and other aspects of my workflow, but generally it's mostly as for entertainment. The PC is included with the RTX 2060 graphics card with the i7 Intel processor, in which I just primarily use it for playing games, streaming, editing, rendering, whatever it may be that needs a more heavier workload. Now onto the peripherals, where I use an Apple Magic Keyboard and a Logitech MX Master 2S mouse, where I feel like these are the most ergonomic and most comfortable peripherals that I've used in the past. I used to have a mechanical keyboard, but I always felt like the Magic Keyboard always fit my type of typing style a lot more efficiently. I felt like the low travel with the keys felt like I was able to type faster and be a little bit more efficient with when I'm typing. I've used a lot of mice in the past, especially when it comes to gaming mice, and I felt like the Logitech MX Master 2S was the one that fit the best in my hand, and it's always been the most comfortable, especially with having to deal with carpal tunnel or arthritis from time to time. Also, having the Bluetooth capability of both peripherals, I'm able to switch between ecosystems pretty seamlessly with Bluetooth connectivity. I really like the custom keys with the Logitech MX Master 2S mouse, being able to switch between 1, 2, and 3 settings based on the system that I'm using. So having the ability to switch between the MacBook Pro and the PC seamlessly with the mouse has been an awesome tool. Now, with being from a work from home situation, I've had to adapt to being able to create content from home. And so in doing that, I've had to develop a system to where I can record and record audio at the same time. And in order to use certain microphones, I've had to use Phantom Powering with the Focusrite Scarlett 2i2 preamp. The reason why I picked this was because I've actually saw some reviews on YouTube that this was the most effective preamp for the Shure SM7B. I think it's a great preamp, being able to adjust the gain in different settings and different preamp settings as well. And it's the most user-friendly for me, which I'm not that delved into audio as much right now. And being able to have a simple interface is great for me. Now, moving on to the microphone and the microphone arm. I use a Gator Frameworks microphone arm to support a Shure SM7B microphone. I currently don't use any cloud lifter adapters or any uplifters to help with the audio levels, so I have to crank the gain on the Focusrite Scarlett 2i2 to almost the max setting. However, the Shure SM7B microphone has been awesome in terms of developing the highest audio quality for videos and for podcasts, as well as answering meetings to where I can feel have a little bit more of a quality assurance with my microphones. Now, along with the microphones, I use a Sony WH-1000 MX3 headphones headset, which is Bluetooth wireless. The reason why I picked this headphone setup was because at the time I felt like this is the best for noise canceling and for audio in terms of editing videos and the audio quality and making sure that I was able to hear every aspect of in terms of sound design. Now, for the other aspects of my desk that kind of bring me a little bit more enjoyment than just having a simple desk setup is the plants that are actually on my desk and are surrounding my desk. I'm a huge lover of plants just because it feels like I have a little more natured and grounded feel within my setup and not always being so sterile with the system that I have in regards to having all this tech and work around me. So on my desk, I have a bamboo plant that I got from a local nursery to kind of give me a little bit more naturey feel. And I personally love bamboo plants because of their ability to kind of adapt and grow slowly and really seeing the progress just from little maintenance. Along with my desk setup, I also have the Monstera close by just because I like to have the natural sunlight, and the actual big leaves kind of gives me that more of a nature feeling that I'm kind of in a tropical rainforest. And for me, I feel like that nature feel provides me the most happiness, and being the most happy in my environment gives me the most creativity. Now, the focus of my desk setup isn't always based around productivity and the tech systems around it, but really providing the most happiness and clarity when it comes to building my ideas. I feel that the most important part of the desk setup is not really always about to be able to flex what you have, but really to incorporate what's the most efficient for you. I've always felt that emotions drive creativity, and being able to have a clear space to be able to absorb and pass through those emotions gives you the best opportunity to succeed and be able to create new content for you. I'm a true believer that it's not about how much stuff you have that makes you the most efficient, but it's how efficient you use the tools that you have on your desk setup. For me, I like to keep everything as minimal as possible, and having to have multiple systems is something that I definitely would like to work back from, and really implementing only one system that I don't have to switch back and forth from. As I continue to grow and continue to be more creative and continue to optimize the workflow, I'll continue to update this and continue to see what makes me the most happy and the most efficient as a human being. I want to take time to thank you guys for everything that you guys have been watching for these videos. And if you have any more comments or any more tips that you guys could provide for me, please comment below, subscribe, and check out more videos that talk about more about happiness and productivity. Thank you all, and see you guys on the next one.